Our knowledge of animal welfare is always evolving. There are things that researchers did in the 80s, even in the 90s, that would not be acceptable under today's standard. Hi, my name's Lindsay Skyner, and I'm Charles Sturt University's Animal Welfare Officer. I've worked with a variety of animals, everything from small rodents to working with wildlife, cattle, and also in zoos. I think the varied background helps me in this role. And I like this role because now I feel like I'm making a difference to the lives of animals. So we need to do the best for the animals that are here for research and teaching purposes. It's important when we're using animals that we realise that it's a privilege, it's not a right that we have to use those animals. So every little thing that we can do to make those lives better while they are giving us data or helping us teach students is really important. What I love about this job is it's really varied, but it does have a regular process as well. On a typical day, I might be having meetings with technical staff. I might be doing observations of research and teaching. I might be doing an inspection of a new facility, like we've just built a new aviary here at Charles Sturt. So with the new aviary build, we'd be making sure that there's no areas that the galahs can rip apart and ingest. So we're looking at it from a health and safety point of view. We're making sure that all the fittings and the fixtures are secure. So if there's branches in there, it's nice to have swinging branches, but making sure that they're safe and they're not going to just collapse underneath the bird. We're making sure that there's the food and water's placed in areas where they're not, you know, directly under branches. Making sure that there's environmental enrichment and those kind of things. We've also got a large herd of horses that live here permanently. We've got cattle, we've got sheep, and we've also got galahs that are used for diagnostic purposes. So they're the animals that live permanently on campus, and that's on the Wagga Wagga campus. We also have fish over in Albury. So we'll have students that will bring dogs and cats in for the day to practice animal handling. We will have pigs that come in for particular projects. We might have chickens come in. So there's a whole variety of animals that we can have at any one time. Technical staff are responsible for day-to-day care, record keeping, and making sure that those animals are in good welfare. I believe that the technical staff are some of the most important people at the university, because if we didn't have them and we didn't have their expertise on the species, the university wouldn't be able to do research and teaching using animals. I'm trying to encourage academics to contact me before they actually submit animal ethics applications to the university. I might see something and be like, oh, is there a way that we can improve that? You know, so it's having conversations with the researchers and looking for ways that we might be able to either refine the use of animals, reduce the use of animals, or even replace the use of animals. And it's not about completely replacing the use of animals. We need to use animals, especially for training vets. So they need to touch animals, they need to have that experience. But if there's ways that we could practice certain things on models prior to them actually using the animals, then it helps to improve animal welfare in general. Animal welfare is an ever-evolving field. There's always new improvements and refinements every day. This makes my role incredibly challenging but rewarding.